What's up, investors? It's the Russian Dude, and in a couple of minutes you will know it as a buyback. And if you want to learn personal finances and investing watching such short videos, please consider liking this video and subscribing to the channel so you won't lose it. Thanks so much, let's get straight to the point. Alright, so buyback is a process when a company repurchases its own shares from the market. And if you're not sure what shares mean, feel free to watch one of my previous videos. And here's an example. One of the reasons why would a company do a buyback is to reduce the number of shares that are available on the market. Buybacks usually lead to an increase in earnings per share, which in return increases the value for existing shareholders. Let's say so at this very moment, company A has 12 million shares outstanding and its net income is $12 million. Then this company's earnings per share is simply $1. But if this company decides to do a buyback and repurchase 2 million shares back from the market, the total number of shares outstanding will be decreased to 10 million shares. And while net income stays the same, which is $12 million, our new earnings per share will be $1.20. As you can see, this is the way buybacks can artificially inflate shareholders' value by boosting EPS. Short-term effects of buybacks might be good, because it increases the value for existing shareholders. But in long-term, buybacks have almost no benefits. A company needs to spend its own money in order to do a buyback, while there can be so many better uses for this money. For example, a company can do more research and development, increase its marketing spendings, or even buy some new assets. And these are just a few examples of how a company can spend this money better rather than just doing a buyback. Things that I just mentioned above is what helps companies to progress and evolve in the future, while buybacks only temporarily boost shareholders' value. Another reason why would a company do a buyback is to prevent another major shareholder from taking over the controlling stake. And it is done so in order for the company's management to keep the control over their company. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions left. Check my other videos if there's anything else interesting for you. Thank you so much, товарищ.